So when I say this, what I was saying to him, and I said, I believe in the I believe family structure is important. I also know that both mass incarceration and financial strain weaken the nuclear family. Without wealth, this becomes an extremely difficult task. Unfortunately, this can't be reduced to just a values discussion. And what they want to say, and this is why you always got to worry about the terrain on which you're having to fight. They want to move the terrain of having to fight from policy to values. Your values are just messed up. You all have bad values. You just don't want to get married. You just don't love each other. You just don't. Your morals are wrong. And you can go all the way back to the Kerner Report and find out the same thing they said then is the same thing we know today. It is not a value discussion. It's a policy discussion. Do not let people like this get you off, because he ran away after I said this, because he wasn't ready for nothing. He's not ready for this discussion. He's only ready for the talking points that somebody has fed him. He's not thinking for himself. And I don't think Jason Whitlock is thinking for himself either. As a matter of fact, I don't think Whitlock is thinking at all. He's just saying some stuff that he knows will drive controversy and drive clicks. And nobody ever says the truth. I don't have proof that you're not stupid. I'm just saying, you saying how you feel don't mean you're not stupid. This is foundational. You have to be able to pass down wealth in the richest country in the world. And then you have to ask yourself, where did our wealth go? Right? And this was him talking about his dad came from Barbados. That's the Cracker Jack box man that just show up to talk. See, we let anybody have a conversation. Okay, anybody can do comedy. Fine. We talked about the comedians the other week. But we let anybody decide they can come and have a conversation on what means something to us. So now white folks is watching saying, well, there's even disagreement amongst the blacks. He should not be able to even go in a restaurant without somebody shouting him down and throwing a biscuit at his head. Because you're getting in the way of what we need to move forward. We're owed that. And then I got another question before I go. If y'all are so opposed to reparations, and if we believe what Jason Whitlock said, let me make sure he said it's a mindset. Whitlock said it creates a mindset of entitlement, right? That's what he said. It creates a mindset of entitlement. I want to make sure I get this dumb stuff right, because it's all regurgitated dumb stuff. I just want to make sure. A feeling of I'm old. So he says reparation creates a mindset of entitlement and a feeling that I am old. That's what he said. Now, I have a question, Mr. Whitlock. I do have a question. And I want to make my question known. Sir, why are you not protesting in New York? New York has secured $183 million in compensation for Holocaust victims and their heirs. Not just the victims themselves, because people tell us, you were never a slave. The victims and their heirs. The New York has gotten money for the victims of the Holocaust and their heirs. Right? $183 million. Why are you, Mr. Whitlock, not protesting that? Because you said you don't agree with reparations and have you told that to your Jewish brothers and sisters? I agree that the Jewish community should chase their money down. Go get it. Mr. Whitlock, have you protested that? Have you ever gone on and said Holocaust survivors and their heirs need to get the money back because it breeds entitlement? I'm just wondering why everybody's so anti-ADOS. Is it the case that maybe you're just racist? Maybe you are a racist man who hates black people, ADOS people. Maybe that's who you are, because it does not make any sense if you hate reparations. And I never hear none of y'all who hate reparations. The idea of reparations is going to make us lazy. Somehow money and wealth only makes us lazy. Everybody else can go get money and wealth all day long. But for us, it's going to make the Negroes lazy. They don't need no money. Why is money only a bad thing? Why is it only when we're owed a debt? It's going to make us lazy. You can always find some little step and fetch it to come out. Well, y'all don't need no money. It's just going to make y'all lazy. Y'all don't need no money. We don't, Negroes don't need no money. They're just going to lay in bed all day. Wait a minute. How come you don't say that to other groups when they go get their reparations? Reparations is a tried and true way to do redress. And it's not our fault that we didn't get it when it was old, because y'all just wouldn't give it. We asked for it. You said you would, and you didn't. Even with Tulsa, we got people who are still alive from the Tulsa massacre, and you won't get them anything. I don't hear you, Jason Whitlock, saying, well, they really want here to get them. You ain't saying nothing. Why are y'all so quiet when other people get? Let me tell you something. Holocaust survivors are getting $1.4 billion in 2024. So, Mr. Whitlock, if this is how you feel about reparations, if you feel that reparations make people lazy and it make them not want to do nothing and it creates a sense of entitlement, if you believe that people are not going to do anything because they're old, how come you won't get on TV? I want you to get on TV, Mr. Whitlock, if you're not a spineless coward, cowardly man, if you're not a spineless racist. I want you to get on TV and say, no, I don't think Germany should do it. I don't think New York should do it. As a matter of fact, Mr. Whitlock, I want you to take a protest sign down to New York. And then maybe if you are consistent on this issue, we will take you seriously. If you are consistent on this issue, right? Maybe we will take you seriously. But from what I see, you don't say this to everybody. These are the questions you have to ask people, because this has happened in this country and other countries. Like New York is chasing down money, and the Holocaust didn't happen in this country, right? We have in this country, though, we have also had Japanese reparations, right? We have had Japanese reparations in this country. And I don't hear Mr. Whitlock shaking his little fist at the air talking about we shouldn't have did that. Oh, but they will pay y'all. They will pay y'all to get on TV and do stuff that harms the people. And I, at this point, I don't know if you stupid or if you think I'm stupid. I don't know whether you stupid or you just think I'm stupid enough to be like, yeah, you right. We don't need no money. Last thing we need is some money. What? Last thing we need is some wealth. Well, we don't have any, and we don't have any because of everything that happened, from housing discrimination with redlining and sharecropping. And we were used as a commodity by white folk to create wealth, and we were not allowed to create our own wealth. And then they stole land from us, and farmland, they stole that. They just plundered us, and we're not supposed to get that back because some little random and some little fat-faced man on TV say what? Who are you? Who are you to say anything about anything? Like, why would that have meaning? He's just projecting the white folk. You know what? I agree with you, sir. Boss man. Boss man, I agree with you, boss man. I'm right with you. I don't think they should get something, boss man, as long as you give me something. As long as you give me a check, boss man, I will absolutely talk against everything you want me to talk against, boss man, because they don't need no money. But I need some money, boss man. Pay me. See, some of these people, as long as they get their individual reparations, they don't care about they don't care about anything that happened. They don't care about the lynchings. I put this up the other day. They don't care about all the lynchings in this country. They don't care about that. They don't care about that we had to leave our homes and our properties and escape to different parts of America because we were getting murdered. No, he don't care about that. He doesn't care about that. He doesn't care about his own people. He ought to be ashamed. His mama ought to be ashamed of him. Like, your parents ought to be ashamed and disgusted. Who is your daddy? Like, who are these people that raised you to get on TV and talk about what we shouldn't have? Who are these people? Who are your people? Used to be a time you could say, who is your mama? Who is your daddy? Right? Racial terror lynches. All of a sudden, none of this stuff matters no more, right? All of a sudden, none of the stuff that happened to us matters. We just got to get out. Well, wait a minute. Nobody told the Japanese. Nobody told the Jewish community. Nobody. And I don't think they should have. I think they were all old. But how come all of a sudden with us, we just got to go without wealth? And we got to listen to this person. He shouldn't be able to go anywhere where Negroes shop without somebody shouting him down. We let people get away with way too much stuff. They get to move around and live life and be happy and don't nobody say. And I'm not talking about doing anything violent, but you shouldn't be able to walk around like that. You couldn't walk around as a member of certain communities saying stuff against that community. I ain't serving you in this restaurant. Go somewhere else. Go let Massa feed you. Ain't that who feeds you all the time? Oh, yard man. What are we talking about? What are we talking about? I mean, what are we talking about?